Good morning. I'm a community activist. How are you? I'm a former educator, and I want to warn you about this dangerous cult, Jehovah's Witnesses. They harbor child abusers. If you Google JW Facts, and also the Australian Royal Commission, there's court cases throughout the world. Finland just came out. There's a story in Canada, W5. It's like 60 Minutes here. They had a whole special. Ireland, United States. They have a two witness rule. Unless there's two witnesses to child abuse, it can't be proved, and they leave it in God's hands to take care of. They don't report it to the police.
Oh yeah, sure.
That's
going to work.
Yeah. Please warn your neighbors, because they come to your door. Pedophiles knocking your door. They know where your house is.
Oh yeah, I want to answer that.
Yeah. Thank you. Have a good day. Thank you. Good morning. I'm a former educator and community activist. Yeah, thank you. JWFacts.com. Please warn your neighbors. It's a community problem. It's a world problem. They're an international cult. They harbor child abusers. They have a two-witness rule. If an abused child as an adult comes out with a repressed memory, if the child abuser denies that the child abuse happened, they do not report it to the police. They do not remove the pedophile from the congregation. They say that it's in God's hands. I'm a first-hand witness to domestic violence in the congregation of Jehovah's Witnesses. I had bruises on my neck, bruises on my arms. I was forced to testify in a back room of elders about this in front of my mother, who was the witness to the bruises. Because there were not two witnesses, the domestic violence was excused. My husband was kept in good standing in the congregation of Jehovah's Witnesses. Please avoid this cult. They're a dangerous cult. They harbor child abusers. JWFacts.com. Please avoid this dangerous cult. I'm a community activist and former school teacher. JWFacts.com. Jehovah's Witnesses harbor child abusers. They shun people if they bring forward information about the two witness rule. They cut them off from their families. They cut them off from their own children, their own parents. I've been shunned for standing up against domestic violence. Jehovah's Witnesses did not honor an order of protection. My abusive husband was allowed to come near my children and myself. I was told, and my children were told by elders of Jehovah's Witnesses, that abuse never happened. My husband was never disciplined for the things that happened in our family, though he was prosecuted by courts and the police. Please avoid Jehovah's Witnesses. They're a dangerous cult. They harbor child abusers. JWFacts.com. There's worldwide lawsuits against them. They require a two-witness rule to child abuse. There has to be two witnesses to child abuse. Though in the Bible, the same scripture they're using, it says if a woman's in the country and she's raped, then she's not to be stoned. But for children, they make it different. They require two witnesses for child abuse. If the abuser says he did not do it, it's excused and left in God's hands. Please avoid JW.org, Jehovah's Witnesses, they harbor child abusers, JWFacts.com. I'm a former educator, and I'm required to speak out for the rights of children. Jehovah's Witnesses harbor child abusers. They will not turn over names of child abusers. They were fined $4,000 a day in California. There are cases against them throughout the world for harboring child abusers in their database. JWFacts.com. Do your research. These people are going to your homes. They have pedophiles in their congregation. Australia Royal Commission. The transcripts of the court cases are online. Candace Conti in California. Padron against Campos in California. These are cases that are out there. You can read the court transcripts. Please avoid this dangerous cult. This is difficult for me to speak out as a survivor of abuse. I do so as a community activist. I do so as a former educator. Please avoid this dangerous cult. Jehovah's Witnesses, they harbor child abusers. They require two witnesses to child abuse. JWFacts.com. There are court cases in Finland, the UK, Ireland, Australia, Canada, the United States. Jehovah's Witnesses harbor child abusers. They require two witnesses, and they do not remove the pedophile from the congregation. If he denies this, they leave it in God's hands. If there's a repressed memory, they say that it didn't happen. Jehovah's Witnesses harbor child abusers. JWFacts.com. I'm a firsthand witness to domestic abuse that's allowed in their congregation. My husband was never disciplined. I presented myself to the elders with bruises. It was excused because I did not have two witnesses to this. Jehovah's Witnesses do not honor orders of protection. This is difficult for me to say. This is difficult for you to hear, but you need to know this. These people come to your door. They harbor child abusers. This is important for our community to know. JWFacts.com. Please know that Jehovah's Witnesses harbor child abusers. They require two witnesses to child abuse. You know, I'm a survivor. This is difficult for me to do, but I feel that it's important for the community to know. I refuse to be a victim. I am a survivor of domestic abuse and cult abuse with Jehovah's Witnesses. Please do your research, JWFacts.com. I have no problem with these people. I have a problem with their governing body. There are 8 men in New York who make these rules. They require that there's 2 witnesses to child abuse. There are court cases throughout the world. Please research JWFacts.com, the Australian Royal Commission. When you even ask about the 2 witness rule and you're a Jehovah's Witness, you're removed from the congregation and you're shunned. Shunning is when you're no longer allowed to speak to your family. Please know that this is a dangerous cult. JWFacts.com. Important to know, these people come to your doors. They allow pedophiles to stay within the congregation. If an elder abused a child and it's more than 3 years ago, he's required to still have authority in the congregation. They go straight to their legal department and any reports of abuse instead of the police. If there's a repressed memory of a child, it's not taken seriously. If the child abuser is not confessing to the abuse, it's dismissed and left in God's hands. Please do your research, JWFacts.com. Important for everybody to know that this cult is tax-free. They go about saying that they help the community. They only help their own members. They are misogynistic people who do not support divorce for domestic abuse. They harbor child abusers. Please know that these people come to your doors. They know where your children are. JWFacts.com. Australian Royal Commission showed that there were 1.5 pedophiles in every congregation in Australia. This has been hidden for years. They refused to hand over their database. In California, they were fined $4,000 a day for not turning over names of pedophiles. In a congregation in California, 2 young men were abused by a man named Campos. Padron and Lopez were the gentlemen who were abused. Jehovah's Witnesses did not turn over the information as regards the case. Their own governing body member, Mr. Loesch, denied any connection with Jehovah's Witnesses when he was in court, stating that he had nothing to do with them, saying that he did not have any part of this just to avoid any entanglement with child abuse cases. Please know Jehovah's Witnesses are a dangerous cult. JWFacts.com. They harbor child abusers. They require 2 witnesses for any child abuse. Otherwise, it's covered up. If there are repressed memories of a child that has been abused, they are told to leave it in God's hands, that it never happened. This happened to me. This happened to my family. I will always speak out as long as I have breath, because I know that life and happiness is more important than loyalty to a cult. Have a great day.